and white dental. This is a common problem. Treatment of gaps, if it happens in the center between two teeth, it's called a midline diastema, but it can also happen in other teeth as well, sometimes in all the front teeth. So there are three ways of treating spaces in your teeth. Number one is by orthodontic correction. Number two is by prosthodontic correction with crowns, and three, a combination of both. So what an orthodontic correction is, when you correct the gaps by repositioning the teeth so that they're close to each other. The advantage of this is it is still your natural tooth and it'll look as beautiful as your natural teeth are, but it does take time because movement of teeth, the bone has to remodel around the new position. So it will take time, maybe a year, maybe less, but it takes time. The second is a quick and easy fix. You just place caps on all the crowns which have gaps in them. The advantage of this is it is fast and it looks beautiful. You can change the color of your teeth. But if the gaps are too big, you run the risk of making your gaps a little wide and it will start to look like Bugs Bunny teeth. So you need to be careful and you need to plan your treatment well. And then finally, it is a mixture of both. So in this case, the teeth were in a very odd position with the laterals missing. So we had to push the centrals together, push the canines away so that there was space for the lateral, and then we had to place a bridge. So either you can do it through orthodontics where you move the teeth, and the results are beautiful. In my opinion, orthodontics is the best. No substitute can be as good as your natural teeth. So orthodontic treatment would be the best treatment for you. If you want a quick fix one, go for a prosthodontic correction in which you get caps done. Prosthodontic correction with crowns can also correct some mismatches in angulations. The change in, you can change also change the color. So there are a lot of advantages for it, but you have to cut your natural tooth. For any crown, you have to cut about 1.5 millimeters around the tooth. So it does make your tooth much smaller. You can either get veneers or crowns. So, but either way, you will have to cut a little bit of your tooth. It essentially is destroying your healthy tooth. You can get veneers done, but veneers sometimes run the risk of adding to your tooth, because whatever your tooth structure is, if you add another layer of ceramic without cutting tooth, ceramic is going to occupy some space underneath your lip, and it sometimes it does make it look a little toothy by pushing your lips a little forward. So planning is very important. You should plan well and execute to perfection, and you will have a great smile.